Welcome to Archival Silence, Closing the Gaps in African American History in Bulloch County, Georgia. Today you will be hearing from the founders and current board of the Willow Hill Heritage and Renaissance Center, as well as the staff from Georgia Southern University Libraries. We will share our efforts to collect and preserve African American history in our local communities. This presentation is part of the Telfair Museum's Legacy of Slavery in Savannah Initiative, an interdisciplinary effort to examine the historical roots of present-day conditions of racial inequality.
I'm Dr. Alvin D. Jackson, a family physician and board president of the Georgia African American Historic Preservation Network, which is a statewide organization dedicated to the preservation of African American history and culture in Georgia. I am also board chairperson of the Willow Hill Heritage and Renaissance Center, a local African American museum and community center, also dedicated to the preservation of local African American history in Bulloch and surrounding counties, and those from Bulloch County who left as part of the Great Migration going to many parts of the United States. I have had long a passion for the preservation of African American history and culture. These origins happened as a lad when I was raised by my grandparents, my grandfather born in 1892 and my grandmother in 1900, both grandchildren of former slaves, who had a great love for history. Often after work, they would sit around with their friends and talk about days gone by. And one of the stories they would talk about was the Willow Hill School, its history being founded in an old turpentine shanty when they went to school there and the great experiences that they had. The other thing I noticed about my grandparents, they collected obituaries, and these obituaries had the lives of individuals who were born in the community, and they collected these and often read them and would talk about them. They would also send me to spend time with many elders who were sometimes sick, that I would spend evenings with them. And when I visited these elders, I noticed that they also collected obituaries. Sometimes they would be out, other times they would be kept away. I would ask to look at them and it would stimulate a conversation. And through these obituaries, I would learn so much about the history of individuals in the community. When I graduated and went on to go to the Ohio State University, I had the honor of meeting Alex Haley, noted historian and the author of Roots. And he really had a strong influence on me in encouraging me to continue the work that I had started many years ago. So when I returned back to the community, I encouraged others to continue to collect obituaries, stories, photographs, and many of these obituaries, stories, and photographs were shared with me. The Willow Hill School, which was founded in 1874, closed in 1999. The Bulloch County Board of Education put it on the auction block in 2005. I, along with 11 other descendants of the school founders, purchased this, and we started the Willow Hill Heritage and Renaissance Center, the African American Museum dedicated to the preservation of African American history. The collection that I had through the community and through working with the local funeral homes represented the basis of starting the archives at the Willow Hill Heritage and Renaissance Center. The Willow Hill Heritage and Renaissance Center has a very important role locally and state and nationally addressing the whole issue of archival silence. Those missing links about African American heritage and history, not in the archives and not in the history books. The conference that we are hosting this weekend as part of the Heritage Festival that we have annually for the Willow Hill Heritage and Renaissance Center addresses that whole role of archival silence. Our goal is to continue research, to stimulate others to do research, to stimulate others to preserve history of our community. Many years ago, many family members after the death would burn up the history of the community. And we certainly have been encouraging others to preserve that history. It is often said that when an elder in the community would die, it was like a library burning to the ground. So we have stimulated our library to retain this history and to save it. There is an African proverb which says that the lion must tell its story, otherwise the hunter will glorify his story. And so that is the basis of what we're doing, to tell our story and to encourage others to tell their story as it relates to African-American history and culture, so that generations that come would understand the important role that African-Americans made to the history of the United States of America.
Hello, my name is Autumn Johnson. I'm the Special Collections Librarian at Georgia Southern University Libraries, specifically in the Zach S. Henderson Library on the Statesboro campus. Similarly to the Willow Hill Heritage Renaissance Center, Henderson Library Special Collections is also a caretaker of historic memory in Bulloch County. I will be sharing with you a bit about our institutions and our efforts to address the silence of African-American archival collections. The Zach S. Henderson Library Special Collections Department was actually founded in the 1970s. Our overall mission today, however, is to collect, organize, describe, preserve, and make available materials of permanent institutional and historic value to our institution, but also the greater community. Our collections include personal papers, organizational records, photographs, ephemera, published material, audiovisual items, and increasingly digitally born materials. Our collections generally fall into a handful of thematic areas. The first, as you would expect, are materials that document the history of Georgia Southern University on the Statesboro campus. Of course, it was not until 1965, some 57 years after the founding of our institution, that John Bradley became the first African-American student at what was then known as Georgia Southern College. That same year, Bradley was joined by six other undergraduate African-American students. It was not until 1972 that Georgia Southern hired its first African-American faculty member, Dr. Charles Bond. African-American student enrollment gradually increased in the 80s and most dramatically in the 90s, and our collections largely reflect that general trend. We see robust coverage of African-American students, faculty, staff, and their experience here on campus and in Statesboro, but there are significant silences in the decades preceding it that we are working to address. In addition to materials reflecting the history of the campus community, one of our other major collection scope is the history of the Southeast Georgia area. Those include the counties of Bulloch, but also Screven, Liberty, Candler, Tattnall, and Effingham County. Our collections, particularly those of personal papers and local organizational records, follow traditional patterns of institutions of our size and reflect those of more elite dominant groups in our area. those that offer documentary evidence on others, including those working class, women, African Americans, and other minority groups, have been comparably underrepresented. Georgia Southern University Libraries has taken significant steps to close the gap, particularly with materials that document African American experience in our local community. We have worked with faculty in their classes to generate greater awareness of known collections and empowered different classes to use these materials as part of their coursework. We have also begun to address inequities in our current archival descriptive practices, a process known as reparative description. This is part of an ongoing professional commitment in the greater archival world to find, assess, and repair descriptions that might make use of harmful terminology or might underdescribe collections of underrepresented groups. We're also closing the gaps by reaching outside of the library and the faculty-centered work of the past. Increasingly, we are working with campus groups, including alumni, as well as special interest student groups, to grow and cultivate collections that represent their particular experience. We've also helped facilitate both undergraduate and graduate student research that increasingly are looking at underrepresented groups and African Americans in our area. And we've worked with them to create and host digital exhibitions and host content on our digital platforms. But most especially, we are working with community partners, especially those that have built trust within their communities. We are working with them to offer our resources, services, specialized support, and expertise to help them continue to offer their ability to preserve the historic memory of their community. Our continued work with the Willow Hill Heritage and Renaissance Center is one such partnership. Alongside our university's public history program, we've worked with Drs. Jackson, their board, staff, and a team of volunteers to gather, preserve, and make available historic content, including digital, to better document the experience of African Americans in Bulloch County, Georgia. Now, my colleagues will actually share the specifics of that ongoing work.
Hi, my name is Jennifer Gerrald, and I'm the Institutional Repository Manager with Digital Commons at Georgia Southern. We are part of the university libraries, and we are assisting the Willow Hill Heritage and Renaissance Center with the project to put the African American funeral programs online. One of the things that I do is I help facilitate weekly meetings with the team who performs the work and the leadership of the center. And what I'd like to do today is tell you a little bit about that team and how valuable their work is to bring this history to the world. The African American Funeral Programs Project was first put online in Digital Commons in 2016, and it was the work of Sarah Napier from the Public History Program. She was in the master's program there. She graduated in 2017 with her Master of Arts in History, and she put the first record into this collection. The material for the collection, the funeral programs, are a part of the private collection of Dr. Alvin Jackson. And the project to grow this collection is still coordinated by the Willow Hill Heritage and Renaissance Center, just as it was when Sarah was working on the project. Sarah has now graduated, and other interns and community volunteers are performing the work to add the records into the collection. Sarah left a manual behind to help guide the work of those who came after her. So one of the things that this collection is doing is bringing to light a history, a valuable history, and making it accessible on a consistent basis to communities. And so what Sarah did, along with the leaders of the center, is lay the groundwork so that the work could also be consistent. This manual that I'm showing right now guides the people doing the work through the process of organizing the funeral programs, scanning the funeral programs, entering the information into the records online and attaching the files, and finalizing the records so that they can be made available. The funeral programs are accessible to each team member through the Google Drive. We do a lot of our work online because our volunteers and interns are not in the same geographic space. And so they can access the folders and files assigned to them by Dr. Jackson from where they are and work in their own space. This brings a consistency to the work when people do not have to find the time to travel and work in the center. Today's team has grown from one person completing a master's program at Georgia Southern, founding the project under the guidance of her faculty, mentors, and the center, into a team of 8 interns and 6 community volunteers. So you can see today's team on the screen. And the team is made up of interns in various programs at Georgia Southern and from community volunteers around Georgia and even one in Ohio. And they bring great expertise to the project. And then our librarians and staff at the university libraries are also working together to make sure that the technology supports the collection as it moves forward. I'd like to share a little bit with you today about our latest report on the project. We do meet on a weekly basis so that the team will have the opportunity to ask questions about the use of the platform and the representation of the records as the center would like to represent them online so that the history of the Willow Hill community is represented in a true way. So from our latest report, our team is made up of a couple of volunteers who have stayed with the project outside of their assignment as interns. The 2 volunteers here that are Georgia Southern student volunteers were interns in the public history program, and they've satisfied that requirement and remained with the project. We also have several community volunteers who are working on the project right now. The leadership of the board members of the Willow Hill Heritage and Renaissance Center, and also the staff, and the staff are supporting the scanning of the programs into these files that you saw in the Google Drive. And then the university library's support is primarily through the Digital Commons team and also some collaboration with the Special Collections team. The collection is getting a lot of attention online, 16,000 downloads as of our latest meeting. And there are 2,635 records in the collection currently, and that's at the hand of these 8 interns and 6 community volunteers who have been working on the project. Preserving the history of the Willow Hill community through this collection really is all about revealing the history of the people from the community. And this project takes the expertise and the dedication of the people of the team to make it work. Dr. Alvin Jackson has collected the funeral programs and preserved them so that we would have content to add to the collection. And then there is work involved to organize and scan the programs, add the records to the platform online, the Digital Commons platform. And these things are so essential to growing this collection. Also, open lines of communication have been facilitated by the faculty members supervising the academic programs, the faculty and staff of the university libraries, and the leaders of the center, with Dr. Nkenge Jackson acting as a primary guide for most of our weekly meetings. So Dr. Alvin Jackson has also joined us in those meetings as the content expert because he has the historical knowledge of many of these families. And without the historical knowledge of the families, we would not know how to adequately represent the people in this collection. So people on the team are key to getting the history of the people of the community online and accessible so that researchers can find out more about this community. Thank each of our current volunteers and those who have brought success to this project to bring these 2,300 records into public view. And I'd like to extend the invitation to any who are interested in becoming a volunteer for this project or signing up for an internship through your academic program to contact Dr. Jackson for the Willow Hill Heritage and Renaissance Center and help us with this project.
Hi, I'm Beth Burnett. I'm the Institutional Repository Librarian for the Georgia Southern University Libraries. Today, I'll be speaking about the collaboration between the Willow Hill Heritage and Renaissance Center and the Georgia Southern Libraries in expanding the discoverability of the African American Funeral Programs collection. First, I'll provide a brief overview of the online archive of the collection. The African American Funeral Programs are physical print documents that are scanned in and digitized. The digital copies are uploaded to Digital Commons at Georgia Southern, the university's online institutional repository. Digital Commons hosts contributions from across the university and the community, including campus documents and publications, faculty and student research, conferences, journals, research data, news, and more. The institutional repository is the secure, permanent collection of original research and creative work of Georgia Southern's faculty, staff, students, and our community partners, such as the Willow Hill Heritage and Renaissance Center. The collaboration between Willow Hill and Georgia Southern has produced two collections of significance to historians and genealogists. Willow Hill, If These Cemeteries Could Talk, which contains church cemetery headstones and tour programs, and the African American Funeral Programs collection that is the topic of this presentation. Now that we have some background on digital commons at Georgia Southern, I'll share some general information about the Digital Library of Georgia. As you might guess from the name, the Digital Library of Georgia collects and provides access to unique resources relevant to Georgia's history, culture, and the lives of its citizens. They collaborate with libraries, museums, and archives around the state to make digital collections freely available online to anyone in the world. Adding collections to the Digital Library of Georgia expands access beyond digital commons at Georgia Southern and increases the possibilities for people to discover and learn from them. As they say on their homepage, the Digital Library of Georgia is a gateway to Georgia's history. So let's talk about how the African American Funeral Programs collections came to be included in the Digital Library of Georgia. In March of 2021, staff at the Digital Library of Georgia contacted the Georgia Southern University Libraries about updating our collections in this statewide database. Although the libraries did have some materials in there, we realized that they were outdated and did not reflect all of the high quality, high impact collections that should be included. In addition to that, Georgia Southern University and Armstrong State University officially consolidated into one institution in 2018. So our collections were scattered and inaccurately organized now that we were the one Georgia Southern University. There were new employees working in both our special collections and digital collections, and there were new collections thanks to our partnership with Willow Hill. Librarians took this opportunity to meet with staff at the Digital Library of Georgia and find out more about how they harvest our collections and how the Georgia Southern Libraries can participate in the process. The Digital Library of Georgia prepared several lists and spreadsheets for us to review. One was a list of the collections currently included in the Digital Library of Georgia. It contained special collections from each of the two physical Georgia Southern libraries. There's one in Statesboro and there's one in Savannah. And it was organized under the pre-consolidation institutional names. So that's when we also learned that technology changes had impacted what was being harvested from the Georgia Southern libraries into the Digital Library of Georgia. The list did not include items that are archived in digital commons at Georgia Southern, which also meant that the Willow Hill collections were not represented. So we scrapped everything and started from scratch. Georgia Southern librarians worked from a spreadsheet of all of our digital collections and reviewed it according to the standards set by the Digital Library of Georgia's collection development policy. Library staff met with Dr. Nkenge Jackson in May of 2021 to discuss getting Willow Hill collections included in this effort. Later that month, the university libraries submitted the African American funeral programs as a new collection for the digital library. And by early July of 2021, the initial harvesting of existing materials was complete, and Willow Hill collections are now included in the Digital Library of Georgia. With that process in place, the African American funeral programs became part of the quarterly harvesting schedule from Digital Commons at Georgia Southern into the Digital Library of Georgia to incorporate newly digitized items. From there, the collections are fed into the Digital Public Library of America. This provides multiple backups on a secure infrastructure and increases the discovery points for researchers, historians, archivists, and genealogists. The funeral programs include valuable information that may be difficult to find otherwise, and they contribute to the public's understanding of local African American history. Examining a large collection of obituaries can also provide information about trends within a community and insight into a particular time period, making them important not only for genealogical research, but as a primary source material for historians. Furthermore, this is part of the important work libraries and archives need to address in remediating long-term underrepresentation of African-American historical documents. Preserving and distributing diverse and inclusive collections, such as the Willow Hill materials, is one way for libraries to support underserved communities. Let's return to Digital Commons at Georgia Southern to view the African American funeral programs collections and provide some usage statistics. The description of the collection is provided at the top of the page. Scrolling down, we arrive at the list of funeral programs. Each one includes a thumbnail image and the name of the person, and you can click through to get additional information as well as download a copy of the funeral program. One of the features of the Digital Commons platform is the readership map at the bottom of the collection homepage. A pin is dropped on the map showing where a reader has downloaded one of the funeral programs. This shows location pins for where people from around the world are downloading documents in our collections. As of August 19th, 2022, over 2,400 documents have been posted. They've been downloaded over 16,000 times from 134 countries around the world. There are an additional 12,000 plus page views of the funeral programs in Digital Commons. This data demonstrates the impact and value of the Willow Hill Heritage and Renaissance digital collections.
Hi, my name is Dr. Nkenge Jackson Flowers, and I am the site coordinator for the Willow Hill Heritage and Renaissance Center African American Funeral Programs Project. The Willow Hill Heritage and Renaissance Center is an African American museum, which is located in the historic Willow Hill School that was founded in 1874. The Willow Hill School is part of the greater Willow Hill community that was started by formerly enslaved individuals during Reconstruction. It is our mission to help to tell the complete American story by including the voices and documents of African Americans in the Willow Hill community in greater Bulloch County, Georgia. And so the Funeral Programs Project is a part of that mission. This Funeral Programs collection, which now numbers around 15,000, was originally the personal collection of Dr. Alvin Jackson, who over the past 35 years recognized the significance of these documents and was on a one-man mission to talk with groups, both large and small, to encourage them to save this history. And this has certainly caught fire because now the museum receives contributions from all over the United States, from those individuals that have descended from the original founders of the Willow Hill community and recognize the importance of saving these collections. And so this project started out as a student project. A public history student, Sarah Napier, under the guidance of Dr. Michael Van Wagnon, started to digitize these programs. She would host digitization parties at the museum using the work of student volunteers. And she also was responsible for creating the manual that we use today. The current program builds upon that work, but is a direct collaboration between the Willow Hill Heritage and Renaissance Center and the Zach Henderson Special Collections Library at Georgia Southern. And their expertise and support has been invaluable and inclusive and has allowed students and the Willow Hill Heritage and Renaissance Center and community members to feel a part of saving this important history. Our meetings, which occur once a week on Zoom, are quite interesting. We talk about programs that have been digitized. We get a weekly report that is prepared by our facilitator, Ms. Gerrald. And we also get on demand or request training and retraining sometimes in the process. And all of this has created a collaborative community, which has allowed us to continue digitizing these documents, which organizations, big and small, know occurs one item at a time. And so we hope that this collaboration can be an inspirational or an inspiration to small organizations like ours that may not have the resources, but have the desire and will to be a part of saving this history. They can hopefully rely on their local university or library to help with the digitization process. And so we invite anyone who is interested in working with this project to reach out to the museum through our email, which is museum@willowhillheritage.org. And we look forward to collaborating with anyone who is interested in preserving history. Thank you.